So what we were trying to do with our naive scaling solution was to decrease the block creation time. Size of the blockchain will increase regardless, since we're assuming blocks stay a constant size and have an increased velocity. We'll look at this problem later. But what are some of the other outcomes of this naive solution that we can take a look at with a more constructive outlook? Recall that another problem with the naive solution was that there was a lot of naturally occurring forks. With our standard fork resolution policy of taking the longest chain as the canonical chain, we'd be wasting a lot of work if the block speed increased. All these orphan blocks that are part of chains that weren't in the end part of the longest chain all represent work that in the end was wasted in a sense. So the problem now is, how can we account for the existence of an increased number of naturally increasing forks when we decrease the block creation time? How do we avoid wasting all of this work? Instead of just increasing the speed of blocks and doing nothing else, the observation here is that we can increase the speed of blocks by specifically decreasing the difficulty of the proof-of-work problem, and also by considering the proof-of-work chain with the most weight, rather than simply the longest chain. And that was the idea behind GHOST, or Greedy Heaviest Observed Subtree protocol, used in Ethereum's proof-of-work protocol. The way it works is that in the GHOST protocol, blocks that are orphaned are called uncle blocks. And uncles up to 7 generations deep of the most recent block also get a block reward. Specifically, uncle blocks get 87.5% block reward, and the children of uncle blocks, appropriately called nephew blocks, get 12.5% block reward. And these blocks are used to calculate a chain's weight. In the end, GHOST reduces transaction time since the blocks are faster. It also decreases the incentive for pooled mining. By rewarding uncle blocks, we've reduced the need for being exactly the first new block on top of the longest chain. Also, since block times are so fast, sufficiently fast miners would want to reduce the overhead of communicating with pools anyways. Ethereum had a period when it had 17-second block times, but now it's been more around 13, 14, 15. If we round to a 15-second block time, then that means that in 60 minutes, the length it takes for 6 Bitcoin blocks to be created, Ethereum has created 40. And though it's been the same amount of time, 60 minutes, for both Bitcoin and Ethereum blockchains to add blocks, it's clear to see that 40 confirmations in Ethereum might be more secure than 6 confirmations in Bitcoin.